All right, Alien Covenant is the prequel, the pre-sequel, right? It's a prequel to Alien, but so was Prometheus.
What was that word you said?
Pre-sequel.
I like it.
Yeah, okay. I feel like there's a better word. There's a more eloquent word for this term.
Eh.
That's fine, right? Should we trademark that?
Probably.
Stats, get on that? Don't use it. I swear to God, you people watching, don't. No, you can use it. We're all supers, right? Is that another trademark?
No.
So Alien Covenant, it's basically the sequel to Prometheus.
I wasn't expecting that at all. I thought it was going to be more of a prequel to Alien.
That's how they sold it.
Yeah, rather than Prometheus, but...
And it's funny, because Prometheus was trying to separate itself. Like, oh, we're in the universe, but it's not an Alien movie. It's a different movie. And it was.
I wasn't expecting it to be so close to Prometheus. I think it's not the sequel I wanted to see from Prometheus, but...
Well, me and you, we both wanted a Prometheus sequel instead of this.
Yeah, it ended up turning out to be a Prometheus sequel, but not the one that I was looking forward to.
Right, a bit too much aliens, and that's something that I never thought I would say. Oh, this movie has too much aliens, which that's why you also like it.
Well, no, just the story in general.
Well, the first one, Prometheus, it's dealing with, the theme is based on the Titan Prometheus, who gave fire to humanity and then was casted out by the gods. And that's what the first film was about. It's about this guy, Wayland, who is trying to find his creator. And then you have the character played by Michael Fassbender, David, who has found his creator, humanity, and he's almost disappointed. And this movie continues that in a way, but it switches to humanity's perspective. I mean, the first one, it had Shaw and Wayland, but this is about humanity colonizing another planet to continue their existence.
Well, I think the movie does a good job of balancing between Alien and Prometheus. You take the horror element of it, Aliens is more action-based, and Prometheus is more ideological. So I think what this movie does well is it takes from Prometheus, but then it also has the Alien feel to it as well.
Yeah, it's kind of like a combination of all three. But I think that's to the detriment of the film. I think it has a tough time balancing all three. The tone is inconsistent. At times, I don't know what the movie wants to be. It seems like we're jumping between different films. Especially with scenes with specific characters, they feel like they're part of a Prometheus film, and then they kind of jump to a film that's Alien.
That's exactly what I was going to say, how it feels in the beginning. It's kind of has the same feel as Prometheus, and then...
Especially that opening scene.
Yes,
no spoilers.
Then halfway through, they try to bridge the gap to Alien. And it seems kind of, I don't want to say rushed, but it just seems kind of abrupt that they just try to have the tones just change about halfway through the film.
One of the biggest criticisms of Prometheus was, where's the alien?
Yeah.
And now in this movie, I kind of want a sequel to Prometheus. Don't go back to the aliens. Because you can only do that film so many times.
I almost would have rather two movies. You had the sequel to Prometheus, and you kind of lead to the prequel to Aliens.
Right.
If that makes sense.
It's almost like they should have made Alien Covenant a combination of just Alien and Aliens, where he should have took the best parts of those two films, rather than try and throw Prometheus in there, because the themes in Prometheus are so much bigger than the first two movies. The first movie is essentially Beowulf, it's Jaws in space. The second one is just a fun horror action movie.
Get away from her, you bitch!
Prometheus, you made a great point. This movie could have been on its own, not even inside that universe.
Yeah, it could definitely stand on its own, and that's the problem. You're taking two different movies that stand on their own, totally separate, and you try to bridge them together.
I thought Ridley Scott did the best with what he was given to make this an enjoyable movie. Because out of all the Alien films, I thought this had some of the most disturbing imagery and scarier moments.
Well, you're going to get that because of, I guess, CG and the advancements in technology since Aliens. I'm not going to count 3 and 4 in this conversation.
Let's pretend that they don't exist.
And in Prometheus, it wasn't as alien-y as the other movies. So obviously you're going to get the visual boost.
Both movies were shot by Darius Wolski, and both films are just beautiful in terms of their cinematography and the way that they're shot. But you prefer the practical alien, because the practical alien still looks great.
Yeah,
when you watch those old movies.
I thought the effects were pretty good. I mean, I actually kind of prefer the Prometheus look.
This one was more, it looked more like an Aliens movie.
Yeah.
It was more in the gutter, it was gritty. Prometheus was a spectacle. They went on the planet during the day. It's just not a nighttime film.
Well, both movies, Prometheus and Covenant, they expand on the world they're in, rather than being contained into either a spaceship or these small enclosed areas.
Well, without spoiling anything, I think the end of this film does open the door for a return of Sigourney Weaver. I think what they were going to do is they were going to do Alien 5 and ignore 3 and 4, and I think they can still do that. Because the first two films are just genre films, but now it seems that they have a story that is not close to being finished.
You just wipe 3 and 4?
Because that's what the studio was going to do. And I think that's what Ridley Scott is going to do. Neil Blomkamp was going to direct Alien 5, and Ridley Scott was like, hold on, kid. I'm Ridley Scott, okay? I've only got about 10 years left on this planet. I'm gonna spend the next decade doing Alien films.
Yeah, and then I'm going to actually live it and go try to find the makers. And then
going to go out, get Michael Fassbender. Yeah. Yeah. Get
Speaking Harrison of Fassbender, Ford. He's probably been the best part of these two movies.
The first Alien film, the best character is Ash and the alien. The second one, it's more Ripley. Prometheus, it's Fassbender. And Covenant, it's Fassbender again. The guy is incredible.
You buy it that he's a
robot.
A synthetic. He's not as... he doesn't act as human as Ash and Bishop were in Alien and Aliens, where you didn't even know Ash was a synthetic in Alien. Spoiler
yes.
from 20 years ago.
But David is definitely more ambitious.
30 years, wow.
And Darth Vader is Luke's father.
Come on, man.
But he's definitely more ambitious, David. But the new one, Walter, he's a bit more like Ash and Bishop. Because David was the villain of Prometheus.
Even though he's probably my favorite character.
Yeah, well, you love him. Because he was a complex villain. You can almost look at him as an anti-hero. He was basically doing what the humans were trying to do. They're trying to find their creator. He found his. He was like, oh, you guys fucking suck. But Walter, he's more part of the gang. And talking about the cast in this film, I thought that was one of the weaker points. The biggest cast that they've ever had, 15 members, and McBride was good. Catherine Waterston was good, but the rest of them...
Very forgettable.
Yeah, expendable.
I couldn't really tell you any purpose they played to the plot besides being
I think
alien
I remember
food.
Ferris was one of their names. And Billy Crudup was the captain, Dr. Manhattan.
Okay.
They were just there to be killed.
They weren't developed at all. I didn't care about any of these characters. Even Danny McBride's character and Catherine
Daniels.
Waterston's... And, yeah, Catherine Waterston's Daniels. I really... did not care, which made Alien and Aliens, like, Ripley is the protagonist and charismatic. She's a likable character. You root for her and you care what happens. I didn't
yes.
feel that at all in this movie.
Jones gave a great performance in the first movie. You know, it's nice to see the dramatic turn of Danny McBride. They're good actors, but I don't want to say that the cast didn't have any chemistry because they didn't try to develop any chemistry between them. The most chemistry they had was the prologue that they released a couple months ago.
Yeah.
When they're all sitting around chopping it up. It's the alien is always the star of these movies. You know, you go to Jaws to see Jaws, you go to Alien to see Alien, you go to Godzilla to see Godzilla. And one of the biggest criticisms of Godzilla, there wasn't enough Godzilla. There was a lot of Alien in this movie. And overall, it's a beautiful film. I thought it was very suspenseful. I thought it was scary. It's more of an Alien film. They succeeded more on the Alien front than they did the Prometheus, because when you're dealing with themes like Prometheus, that needs to be your central focus. It can't be a side story. I really like the film. I would give it 8 out of 10.
I'm not as high on it as you are. I'd probably give it a 6. I think I'm more upset that it kind of just blew by the Prometheus plot.
Yeah, I can understand that.
Went right back to Alien, which I guess it's the Alien franchise, but I just don't see how you can make this whole movie, a whole prequel, disregard it like that.
So you give it a 6 out of 10?
Yes.
Can you look into this egg for me real quick?
This one right here?
Yeah.